Lesson 71, Altitudes, Medians, and Perimeters. In the last lesson, we learned how to use similar triangles to prove that line segments are proportional and that angles are congruent. You remember the way it works. Once we've proven that two triangles are similar, we know that all three of their angle pairs have to be congruent. And that's how we can prove that a pair of angles are congruent, as long as those angles are parts of the similar triangles. But then the corresponding sides of the similar triangles have to be proportional. So that's the way we can do this. Prove that line segments are proportional, as long as those line segments are corresponding sides of the similar triangles. Well, it turns out we can also prove some other things about similar triangles. We're going to go through those in this lesson. Let me put up a diagram to just get started on the first one. Here are two triangles, and then we know that they're similar. We're given that here at the bottom. And then notice that we have line segment BD and FH that are drawn. And then these, you remember, are altitudes. An altitude of a triangle is just a line segment that's drawn from one of the vertices of the triangle, like this one's drawn from vertex B, to the other side, and it's drawn so that it's perpendicular to this other side. So this is a right angle. And then we have the same situation here with FH. It's drawn from vertex F, and then this is also a right angle. Now, since ABC and EFG are similar triangles, we know that the ratios of their corresponding sides have to be equal. See, if we take AB and divide it by EF, those are corresponding sides, we get 40 over 20, which equals 2. And then if we take BC over FG, we get 30 over 15, and that also is equal to 2. And then AC divided by EG is 50 over 25, which equals 2. And so that's showing that the ratios of the corresponding sides are equal. That's another way of saying that the corresponding sides are proportional. But what about the altitudes of these similar triangles, BD and FH? Well, let's just divide those. And I put the side from the larger triangle on top in every one of these, and so I'm going to put BD on top and FH on bottom. And I end up with 24 over 12, which is equal to 2. So do you see that? The ratio of the altitudes is equal to the ratios of all of the corresponding sides. And that was no coincidence. There's a rule of geometry which says for any pair of similar triangles, whatever the ratio of their corresponding sides, and in our example, the ratio was 2 for all of the pairs of corresponding sides, whatever that is, the corresponding altitudes must have that same ratio. And that's what we saw. When we divided the altitudes, the ratio ended up equaling 2 again. Now, let me explain what corresponding altitudes means. BD and FH are corresponding because this one's drawn from vertex B and this one's from vertex F. And then notice those are in the same position. They're both in the middle. And then another way to tell is that BD is drawn to side AC and FH is drawn to side EG. And then if you look down here, AC and EG are in the same positions, first and third, first and third. So that's how you tell whether two altitudes are corresponding. Now let's go through a proof of this rule about altitudes of similar triangles, and I'm going to go through the proof informally. We're given that triangle LKJ, which is right here, and triangle PON are similar, and then we're also given altitudes KM and OQ. And you see those that are drawn in. Those are right angles, of course. And then we need to prove that KM over OQ, that's the ratio of the altitudes, we need to prove that that is equal to the ratios of the corresponding sides. See, KL over OP, those are corresponding sides. And then notice how we've got KM on top, and that's the altitude from the larger triangle. And then we have KL on top here, which is the side from the larger triangle. And it's the same for each of these. KJ over ON, that's another pair of corresponding sides, and LJ over PN. And so this is going to prove that rule that I just told you, that the ratio of the altitudes agrees with the ratios of the corresponding sides. Here's how we do it. The first step is to show that angle J is congruent to angle N. And we know that that has to be true because these are similar triangles. And we know that all three of the angles of the corresponding angles have to be congruent. That's just by the converse of the definition of similar triangles. And then the next step is that KMJ and OQN are congruent because those are right angles. And then that means that triangle KMJ is similar to triangle OQN by angle-angle similarity. See, KMJ and OQN have to be similar because of these two angles and these two angles are congruent. But that means that KM over OQ must equal KJ over ON, because those are just corresponding sides of these two similar triangles. See, KM is a side now. It was the altitude of the big triangle, but it's just a side of KMJ, and then the same thing here. OQ is just a side of triangle OQN, and so this ratio, or this proportion, I should say, has to be true. KM over OQ equals KJ over ON. But then we were given that triangle LKJ is similar to triangle PON, and that means that their corresponding sides have to be proportional. In other words, KL over OP has to equal LJ over PN, which has to equal KJ over ON. See, all of those are corresponding sides of the big triangles. But then we just showed that KM over OQ is equal to this one right here, so it must be equal to these other two also. And that proves that KM over OQ is equal to all three of these ratios. And that's just by the transitive property. Now let me show you the official version of this theorem about the ratio of the altitudes of similar triangles. This is going to become our theorem 53, and it says if two triangles are similar, then the lengths of a pair of corresponding altitudes have the same ratio as the lengths of any pair of corresponding sides. And then with this theorem, we now have another way to use similar triangles to prove that two line segments are proportional. We just prove that the triangles are similar, and then if the line segments that we're wanting to prove are congruent happen to be altitudes of those similar triangles, then we can use this theorem to do that. Now the next thing that we're going to learn to do with similar triangles is to prove that the medians of similar triangles are proportional. See, here are a couple of triangles and they're similar, ABC and DEF, and then BR and ET are medians. And remember, a median is a line segment that's drawn from a vertex and it's drawn to the midpoint of the opposite side. So R is the midpoint here of line segment AC, and then T is the midpoint of line segment DF. And what we're going to prove is that if we take the ratio of BR to ET, see BR over ET, that that has to equal the ratios of the corresponding sides. See, AB over DE is equal to BR over ET, and then here are the other ones. They're all equal. It works just like the altitudes. Now let's go through the proof of this one, and I'm going to do this informally too, just like the last one. The first step is that since these two triangles are similar, we know that AB over DE, those are corresponding sides, must equal AC over DF, another pair of corresponding sides, and that has to also equal BC over EF. So in other words, all of the corresponding sides are proportional, and that's by the converse of the definition of similar triangles. You know, since they're similar, that has to be true. And then the next step is actually kind of fancy. We take one of these ratios, AC over DF, and then we divide the top and bottom by 2. And that'll give us AC over 2, and then down here DF over 2, or you could write it as 1 half AC, 1 half DF. And then you could, instead of using division, you could just multiply the top by 1/2 and the bottom by 1/2. That's legal, of course, because you're just multiplying the top and the bottom by the same number. That's the same as just multiplying the whole fraction by 1. So it doesn't matter whether you call this the division property or the multiplication property, but we know that AC over DF is equal to 1/2 AC over 1/2 DF. You're just multiplying the top and the bottom of a fraction by the same number. That doesn't change the fraction's value. But we know that R is the midpoint of AC and T is the midpoint of DF. And what that means is that RC must equal 1/2 of AC, because see, that's just 1 of the halves. And then TF has to equal 1/2 of DF. But then look, we can now substitute RC for this numerator and TF for this denominator. And that gives us RC over TF equals BC over EF. Let's just see where these are. Here's RC, here's TF. Those are the halves of the bottom sides. And then here's BC and EF. But then since ABC and DEF are similar, we know that angle C and angle F are congruent. But look at what that means. We now have a pair of congruent angles. We have RC over TF is equal to BC over EF. The sides connecting to those congruent angles are proportional. And so by side angle, side similarity, we know that triangle BRC is similar to triangle ETF. Now this is a pretty tough proof, so try to stay with me. See, it's by side-angle-side similarity. These are the angles, and then this side divided by this side is equal to this side divided by this side. That's shown right there. And then that just means the sides connecting to the angles are proportional. So now we know that these two triangles are similar, and that must mean that BR over ET is equal to BC over EF, because now BR and ET, they're no longer medians, they're just corresponding sides of these similar triangles. And then that's just by the converse of the definition of similar triangles, we know that since the triangles are similar, that all of the corresponding sides have to be proportional. But BC over EF is just one of the pairs of corresponding sides of these original triangles ABC. So if BR over ET is equal to BC over EF, then it's equal to all these others too. It's equal to AB over DE, and it's equal to AC over DF. And that's our proof statement. The medians, BR and ET, the ratio of those is equal to the ratio of all three pairs of corresponding sides of these triangles ABC. That's the proof. Now let me show you the official version of this theorem. This is going to become our theorem 54. It says if two triangles are similar, then the lengths of a pair of corresponding medians have the same ratio as the lengths of any pair of corresponding sides. And we can use this theorem to prove that a pair of line segments are proportional as long as those line segments are medians of similar triangles. Now the last rule that we need to go over in this lesson has to do with the perimeters of similar triangles. And what this rule says is that if we have two similar triangles like RST and UVW, if you take the perimeter of RST, which you just go all the way around the triangle, and then you do the same thing for UVW, you go all the way around, and you divide those numbers, then that's going to equal the ratio of any of the corresponding sides of the two similar triangles. And I've just got one of the corresponding sides here, RT over UW, but it would be the same for any of the other pairs. And this is another pretty tough proof, and I'm going to try to go through it quickly because this is a long lesson. The first step is that RT over UW is equal to RS over UV, which is equal to ST over VW, and that's just saying that all of the corresponding sides of these two triangles are proportional. Those ratios are all equal, and that's by the converse of the definition of similar triangles. And then now we're going to do some algebra that's actually pretty complicated. We're going to set each of those ratios equal to some number k, which is right because all the ratios are equal, so they're all equal to the same number. We don't know what it is, but we'll just let that number be represented by k. And then the next thing we're going to do is get rid of the fraction in each of these little equations. We'll multiply the sides of this one by UW, and we'll multiply both sides of this one by VW, and both sides of this one by UV, and that gives us this. RT equals K times UW, ST equals K times VW, and RS equals K times UV. And then the next step is we're going to add the left and right sides of each of these equations together. In other words, we'll take RT plus ST plus RS equals these three things added together, and that gives us a long equation. And notice that this side is the perimeter of this triangle. Do you see that? RT plus ST plus RS. And then we're going to do a little more algebra here on the other side. We can actually factor out a k from these three terms. It's really like factoring whenever you're reducing a fraction. We're going to reverse distribute. It's like distributing in reverse. We'll take a k outside the parentheses and then leave UW plus VW plus UV inside. And that gives us this. The perimeter of RTS is equal to some number k times the perimeter of the other triangle, because see, UW plus VW plus UV is the perimeter of this one. And now all we have to do is divide both sides of this equation by the perimeter of UVW. That's going to cause this whole thing to cancel, and then the quantity here will end up in the bottom of a fraction over here on the left side. And so the ratio of the perimeter of this triangle to the perimeter of this triangle is equal to k, but that's the same number that we said the ratio of all the corresponding sides were equal to. Remember that? We had that RT over UW was equal to k, and then all of the other sides' ratios were also equal to k. Well, it's also true for the perimeters. And that was a very tough proof, and you shouldn't expect yourself to be able to do that one on your own. But the point is that this rule about ratios being equal, it works for altitudes, it works for medians, and it also works for perimeters. If you have two similar triangles, the ratios of the corresponding sides are equal, but so are the ratios of the altitudes equal to the ratios of those corresponding sides. The ratios of the medians have the same answer, same result when you divide those, and it's also true for the perimeters. Now let me put up the official theorem for this one. This one's going to become our theorem 55, and it says if two triangles are similar, then their perimeters have the same ratio as the lengths of any pair of corresponding sides.